Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the namespace and variable scope and LEGB rule. Today in this tutorial, we are discussing about the closures. But to understand the closure, we need to understand two more concepts. The first one is we need to know what is nested function. Second one is we need to know functions are objects. Okay, so I'll explain you about this. First, we'll see what is nested function. So if I define a function inside another function, then that is called as nested function. For example, in the Python file, I'll take a function called outer, and here I'll take x is equal to 3, a variable, and I'll define an inner function, print x, and I need to call this inner function inside the outer function, and at last I need to call the outer function. Okay, so here we can see a function that is outer. Function name is outer. Inside that function body we can see a variable x. Okay, it is assigned to value 3, and next here we can see another function definition. The function name is inner, and in the function body we can see it is printing the x value, and here we can see the function call to that function. Okay, so here we can see the outer, that is the function call to the outer function definition. So now if I save this and run this, it will give the output as 3. So that is the x value. Here we can see, here this outer function is the enclosing function. This inner function is the nested function, because this function is inside another function, right? And here this nested function can use the enclosed variables or the names which are defined in the enclosing scope. Okay, this is the enclosing scope. Okay, here x is equal to 3, this is the enclosed variable. We can use that inside this nested function. All right, this is about the nested function. And I can't call this function outside this function body. For example, now here if I call this inner function, okay, here we can see the error, name error, name inner is not defined, because this is the local function to this function. Okay, we can't call this function outside this outer function body. Okay, so this is about the nested function. Okay, so next concept is functions are object. So in Python, functions are object. We can assign a function to variable. That's nothing but, first I'll define a function. I'll just give name as f, okay, and it will just print hi. Okay, so now to call this function, I need to write the function name and parentheses, right? So it will print the message hi. So now if I just mention the function name, okay, I won't call this function. To call this function, I need to use parentheses, but I'm not calling this function. I'm just mentioning a function name, and if I enter, we can see function f at this location. Okay, here we can see the function object reference, and in Python I can assign this to an variable. So if I take a variable called g, if I take f, okay, g is also same. Okay, g is the another name given to that reference. Okay, so if I call g now, it will print hi. Okay, so if I call a function without parentheses, it will give that function reference. Okay, so now coming to this closure concept. Here, as I said, I can't call this inner function. Okay, so I'll delete this. So now here we can say I'm calling this inner function inside this outer function. Okay, so now instead of calling this function, what I'll do is I'll return this as well as I'll call this function. Okay, so here I'm returning something. That's why here I'll take a variable or a name. Okay, I'll see what it is returning. Okay, so I'll print that also. Now if I save this and run this, so here we can see 3 and none, it is returning nothing. Okay, so this is not the value returning function, that's why it's not returning anything. So if you want to see the value, then I can say as y is equal to 3. It will return 6, because here we can see this inner function is returning the result, that is the, it will add 3 plus 3, 6, it will return that result and it will return that to here, so a value will be 3. Okay, so as I said, if I write a function with the parenthesis, that is function name with the parenthesis, then we are executing that function definition. But if I remove this, so here we are returning the this function reference, inner function reference to here. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, it will return this. Here we can see function outer locals inner at this position. Okay, so that is nothing but if I print the name of A, that is nothing but which function it is pointing to. Here we can say inner, so that is nothing but A is nothing but the inner function. Okay, so here we return the inner function reference, right, and we are took the name as A, so that is nothing but A is same as inner function. A is nothing but the inner function. Here we can see when I check the name, we can see the inner in the output, right? So here name A and inner are pointing towards the same function. Okay, so I'll remove this, I don't want to print this now. Here I know this A is nothing but inner function, so I can't call inner function here, right? If I call that inner function, I'll get name error. We tried that. So if I want to see, we'll get name error. So here we know that A and inner are the same, so I'll try A here. Okay, I'll call function A here, and if I save this and run this, here we can see it will return a result. So if I print this, I want to print it, right, to it will return 6. Okay, so that means we executed this inner function body outside its scope. Okay, this is the local function, we executed it outside that function. Okay, but we know that we can't call a function outside its scope, then how we are getting this output? This technique is called as closure. Okay, here function A and inner are the same function, and we are executing this function outside its scope. Okay, this technique is called as closure. The technique by which some data gets attached to the code is called as closures in Python. Or another definition is, closure is a function object that remembers values in the enclosing scope even if they are not present in memory. Okay, so this is about the closure. Okay, so next I'll take another example. Okay, so here we can see the outer function, inside that we can see a message and inner function, and here we are returning the reference of inner function. Okay, and here we can see we took a name A. Okay, that reference will be stored in this, and next I'll call this function, because this inner function is the non-value returning function. Okay, it will print message, so no need of printing this, so I'll just call the function. So now if I execute this, it will print hello. So here what happened is, we called the outer function. Okay, so this outer function will returns the reference to this inner function, right? Next we called this A. because A is pointing towards the function inner, we called that and we got the result. Even though we finished the execution of this outer function, then also the message hello is remembered and it is printed. Okay, so this technique is called as closure. Okay, so next question is, when do we have a closure? What are the criteria needed to create a closure in Python? So the first one is, we must have a nested function. Okay, so that is function inside another function, and the nested function must refer to a value defined in the enclosing function. So in the example we saw, so the message was the enclosed variable that was used in the local scope. And the last one is, the enclosing function must return the nested function. We saw, right? It will return the reference to the nested function. Okay. These are the criteria to create the closures in Python. So next, if you ask what are the advantages of closures in Python? So the first one is, we can avoid the global values. Here we can see, we call the local function outside its scope. We printed the enclosed variable outside its scope, right? So we can avoid the global names using this closure. And the second one is, it provides some kind of data hiding. Third one is, it allows us to implement the decorators that we'll discuss in the next tutorial. Okay, so that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.